Hi everyone, so on my short video, I was showing this piece that's a corner to corner or C2C, and you are starting here, which is your corner, and you're going back and forth this way instead of this way. Like that. The whole piece consists of double crochets, US term. In the UK, it's considered a treble. Same thing. So first you're going to make your loop. Pull it up, put your hook on, we're going to chain six. When I get to my third chain, I am going to put my thumb there, and I will tell you why. Hold my thumb, three chain, and then do three more. Okay? I say that because otherwise, never count the hook, yarn on your hook. You'd have to count back one, two, three, four stitches every time. If you hold your thumb there, you know exactly where you gotta go each round. So go where your thumb was on the third chain up and do a double crochet. Yarn over, go to the next and do another double crochet. Next is your last, right there. Do a double crochet. And you have your first cluster done of four double crochets. So now you're gonna chain six again. Hold your thumb on that third, four, five, and six. And do the same thing. A double crochet where your thumb is. Fourth stitch down from your hook. One. Go to the next one right there. Two. And so now you'll have something that looks like that. Okay? What you're gonna do is flip this piece over and go into the top hole and do a slip stitch, just like that. There's your corner. You're gonna chain up three, whoops, two and three. You gotta hold it loose. I'm holding it too loose. Tension, very important. Okay, and three. One, two, three. Never count the one on your hook as a chain. Do three double crochets into the hole. Okay? Like that. So now you have something kind of looks like a heart. Only a little bit longer on this end. So now you want to increase and you're going to do chain six. Again, I like to hold my thumb on the third chain, do three more. That way I eliminate the counting. I know exactly where I gotta go, right where my thumb is, and do a double crochet. Go into the next stitch, do a double crochet. And you'll do three of these each time, but you'll end up with four because of the turning. And then this is the last one right here. And go through, double crochet. Make sure this is up, that this longer piece is always facing up, okay? Now go through this hole, slip stitch it through, chain three, one, two, three, do three more double crochets into that same hole. This is a polyester, I think it's a smart saver yarn or something. It's a little rough. I wouldn't use it for baby blanket, but for just illustrating and showing you how, I don't mind using it. I made Santa hats with it. Okay, you got four. Go into the end, top hole, do a slip stitch, chain three, one, two, three, and do three more double crochet into that same hole. Okay. Total of four in each of these holes that you do. Now you're going to chain up six. One, two, three, four, five, and six. Oops. Oopsie. Six. And then go right where your thumb is and pull a loop and do your first double crochet. You'll have two because of the turning of skipping those first three stitches. Makes your first double crochet. So So you will have a total of 4 when you're done and you get to this next section. Okay. Turn it up. Go into this top hole. Do a slip stitch. Chain up 3. Do 3 double crochets into the stitch. Right here. That's 3. One more. If you like it and you want to subscribe, I'd appreciate it. If I can get to 50, then we could do the lives and work together and ask questions and I can answer them for you. Slip stitch, chain 3, go through the same hole and do 3 more. Hold this down if it gets in your way. It does mean sometimes until you get it bigger. Okay, that's 3. One more, total of 4. Okay, 1, 2, 3, and 4. Slip stitch in the end. Do the same thing. Chain 3. Do 3 more into this hole right here. For a total of 4. 1, 2, and 3. Okay. And that's what we got so far. Now you're going to do the chain 6. 1, 2, 3. I'm going to hold my finger. 4, 5, and 6. Again, if you don't want to hold it, don't count the one on the hook. Count back 4 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4. Double crochet right where your thumb is. Pull a loop up. Pull through. Pull through. Go to the next one right there. Push your yarn through, your hook through, pull a loop up. Make sure you pull them up so they're all the same. Next one is the last one right here. And you could hold this piece and just pull up and make sure they're all straight. Go through 2 and go through 2. Okay. Next one, go through this next hole, top stitch, do a slip stitch. I'll put that down out of the way and do chain 3. Chain 3. Same hole. Do 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Next one, go through the first hole, slip stitch, chain 3. 1, 2, 3. Same hole, do 3 more, double crochet. The whole blanket will be, whole blanket in my case, will be all double crochets. And each of these sections will have 4 double crochets. Oops, next one, slip stitch first, very important. Chain 3, tuck that down if it's in your way. And do 3 more double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. We're at the end. Top of the stitch. Slip stitch. Chain up 3. 1, 2, and 3. Go through the same hole and do 3 more double crochets. That's 1. That's 2. And that's 3. Okay, can you see how it's coming out? So now chain up 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. Yarn over, go right where your thumb is. And you're going to do 3 double crochets. That's 1. And then the next one is right there is 2. And 3. And again, you'll have 4 due to the fact that when you did the chain of 6, you turned and you went into the 4th chain. So when you turned it, it makes a stitch. So now we go back in this one, slip stitch, chain up 3, double crochet 3 more into that same hole. That's 1, 2, and 3. Next one, go into that top slip stitch. 1, two, and three, and then do three more double crochets. One, two, and three. Next one, go through the top hole, slip stitch, chain three, one, two, and three. Do three more double crochet into that same hole. That's three, and one more makes four. Go into the next one. I'll go slow. Slip stitch, chain three, one, two, and three. Then do three more double crochets into the same hole. One, two, and three. You have four. One, two, three, four. We're at the end. Slip stitch, chain three, one, two, three. Then you're going to do three double crochets. That's three, one, two, three. Last one makes four. Each one will have four. Okay, we're at the end. We did our last set of four. Now we're going to chain up six. One, two, three. Again, I like to hold it. Four, five, and six. And six. My yarn. Okay. So we're here. Now what you want to do is turn your work around. Yarn over. You don't have to turn it, but either way, yarn over. And I took my thumb off, so I'm going to count one, two, three. Right there. Do my double crochet. That's one. Next one is right there. That's two. One more right there. Makes three. But because you did a turn and chain, you have four. One, two, three, four. Okay. To connect, you go through that top hole with a slip stitch like that. Chain up three. And then do three more into that same hole. One, two, and three. Okay, I'm going to stop there. As you can see, we're working diagonally. So you have a chain of a cluster of four double crochets. Slip stitch into this next hole here, right here, chain up three, do three more double crochets, do a slip stitch into the next one, chain three more double crochets for a total of four, slip stitch into the next top, chain three more double crochets, go to the next one. Chain three, slip stitch, chain three more double crochets for a total of four. If you turn it, you could see one, two, three, four. Okay, then here's the side, the end. You're going to go into the top, chain three, first do your slip stitch, chain three more double crochets, and because it's the side, after you do the cluster of four, like this, then you're gonna chain up six, and then turn your work and go back and forth. Now, as you can see, we're working this way. And you can see, this is the corner. It starts with one, then you got two, then you got three, then you got four, then you got five. You can count, this is how you'll know if you're messing up. One, two, three, four, five, six is the last one I ended at, okay? But when you're done, in actuality, this is the blanket. That's why they call it corner to corner. This is how it's going to be done. It's going to look like that. So you're working like this. Eliminates that first row of chains. Beautiful. Those get to be a pain when you're doing a big project. And that is the corner to corner, otherwise known as a C2C. It's a very nice pattern. It goes fast. There's no real counting. Once you get the hang of this, you won't be counting much. You'll just be doing on autopilot. Again, if you like what you see and you want to keep going and learn, hit the subscribe button. Give me a comment. Let me know what you would like to see, if you liked it, if I went too fast, if I'm talking too fast. Just let me know. Thanks for watching.